Hello. In this video, I'm going to talk about setting up a Ubiquiti UniFi controller and Docker on a Synology NAS. So I have a Ubiquiti UniFi access point, and I'll put a link in the description to that video or any videos related to that. And I have a Synology 918 NAS. I'll put a link in my Synology playlist in the description also. But in order to use these Ubiquiti access points, the UniFi ones, you need to have a controller, which is like the software used to configure it. So you can just install that on your PC, but there's a couple other places you can put it. You can put it in the cloud, like at AWS or Microsoft or something, or you can install it on a NAS device, which is what I want to do. So I'm essentially going to be following the directions on this Mike Tabber's blog, I think it is. And I'll put a link in the description to this. I mean, I could just tell people, hey, go look at this article. When I do the configuring of the access point, I want to be able to reference this video where I actually set it up in case people have questions. So first, what you need to do is you need to log into your disk station manager interface and then go to Package Center. And then you can go here to search and search for Docker. And we'll hit install here, and it'll just take a little bit of time to install. So what Docker is, it's kind of like a virtual machine type environment where you can run applications, and it's a little bit lighter weight than a full-on virtual machine. Okay, Docker is now up and running. We can hit open here, and let's see, we'll close this. And here we have Docker running. So we can, I'll just minimize this, and I'll close the install window. And then I'll open up the instructions here, get out of full screen. Okay, and what I want to do is open a terminal. So I'm gonna hit Command Space to open up Spotlight Search, and I'll just type in terminal. You can also go to your application folder or whatever. And I have the terminal window here. So what we want to do is we're gonna, first steps is SSH into your NAS. So what you wanna do is you want to type SSH and then your username and your NAS IP address. So, you know, looking at the NAS here, here's the IP address in the address bar. I'll type that in, I'll hit enter. And this is my first time using SSH to log in. So I'll say I want to continue, yes. And then it's asking for the password. So this is the password of the NAS. So I hit that and I'm in the NAS. So if you're on a Windows machine, you can use something like PuTTY to do this. If you're on Linux, you can just use the terminal in Linux to use SSH to get into the machine. So now we're on the command line. Of the NAS, and it says first let's create a new folder called UniFi located in Docker. So if I hit pwd, which is the shows the working directory, we're at the root directory. If I type ls, you'll see on the right side here there's a volume 1, and you'll see referenced in the instructions there's a volume 1. If you have something besides volume 1, you'll want to use that in your build. So I'll type in mkdir or make directory, and then I'll say /volume1 and then /docker. So if you aren't familiar with command line in like Linux, you can start typing as command line completion. So I can type un here and hit tab. That didn't work. Type uni, unif. Oh wait, pardon me. So like Docker, I can type do, hit tab, and it'll complete it. UniFi hasn't been created yet, so that won't work. So I'll type UniFi, and that will make a directory in Volume 1 Docker called UniFi. So I'll scroll down here, and it says, let's pull or download the UniFi controller Docker container from Docker Hub by typing the following command. So I'll copy this, and I'll paste it over here. And it's going to ask for my password. I'm typing sudo here. That says do this with root privilege. So this will download the Docker container. Okay, that's completed. So now I'll go to the next step number four. It says let's run the new UniFi controller container by typing the following and then replace volume one with the volume you have. So we have volume one. So I'll copy this. And I'll paste it and I'll hit enter. Okay, so now it says open a web browser to this IP. So I'll just copy what I had here. Well, I'll just start a new tab. Let's see, new tab. And the port, I'll just copy this. That'll be easy. So I'm going to copy this URL and I'll add in here my IP address of my NAS. Okay, so I'm going to get this page saying the connection is not private. This is would be because it has HTTPS up here and it doesn't have a like a global certificate in it. So I'll hit show details. I'll say visit this website and it will ask me my password. This is to make sure that I'm aware it's opening a page that may not be safe. So let's see. So this is the basic of installing the UniFi controller in on a Synology NAS using Docker. So I won't say this is like the most comprehensive install video. You know, there may be better instructions out there. This is just one I found and it was real quick. I want to make a quick video on it. In my next video, I will actually connect up, I'll configure this and connect up my UniFi wireless access point. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click like and thanks for watching. Goodbye.